Anytime he turns on his car, like so many ServiceNow like signs come up on the dashboard.
Bro,
you really need to get that.
Why are you throwing shit at my car, man?
Yeah, I think guys, I'm gonna start a GoFundMe. Link in the description. All right, bro. Listen to this. So we are on the NF journey again. This is the last song on the Therapy Session album. It's called Statement.
And it's not the last song. It's the last recommended
song.
Well,
it's the last song from the list.
From the list, yeah.
But
yeah.
I think we've reacted to like 8 or 9 songs from the album. So clearly it's a very important album. Mm. There's, you know,
a lot of songs,
few good
it?
Songs on there. Yeah, so let's jump straight into it.
But looking at it, looks like we've got actually 14 songs in this album.
Yeah.
So there's some
we
songs.
We did most of it, though.
We did a lot of it. Let's check out some of the others we haven't done in a long time. Because we can finally listen to them properly. Okay, let's go.
Guys, we've been recording videos in here for the last like couple of hours, and the car has been so hot, and like to the point where like laptops are crashing. Like
it's not the car's problem; it's our laptop. I think that's a problem.
Yeah,
it's just so hot in here.
Yeah.
So we had to, just keep
open the windows and everything.
Yeah. But we can relate.
It's just funny that you mentioned that. And I know it sounds funny, but it's real life. Yeah. I know it sounds funny, but it's real life. I was also just thinking about used to drive
my
a car that running right. This guy, anytime he turns on his car.
Wait. Perfect example is here. Listen to this.
Well, the squeaky windows, but anytime he turns on his car, like so many ServiceNow like signs come up on the dashboard.
Bro,
you really need to get that.
Why
that
are you throwing shit at my car, man?
Yeah, I think guys, I'm gonna start a GoFundMe. Link in the description. Thank God for the hard times, cause I guarantee without them wouldn't be here. Let's be clear, I was given 2 cars. I ain't really had the money trying to rap, making 9,000 a year. I don't say it so you feel for me, I say it cause it's real to me. I go to my grandma's office, she can make a meal for me. Now I got some labels on the table saying that they got a deal for me. Yeah. I can feel it. Really good production on the chorus, actually.
On the music, right?
Yeah. I feel like this is like his niche. He has my favorite songs of NF is when the production is really, really rich.
Yeah, you're right. When there's a lot of mix between rapping and other like.
Yeah, like there's a melodic bit where he's singing, and then he's got the verses in between. But then also the beats are really,
really
like thick and rich. I don't know how to explain it, but. Michigan, that morning's cold. We don't want to turn on the heat, keep the bills low. We're sitting in the living room in our winter coats. Yeah, we're sitting in the living room in our winter coats. Me and my roommate, we like downtown town in the Grand Prix.
They're going through a living crisis right now.
Yeah.
Oh, that last winter was rough, not gonna lie.
Yeah, trust me. But when I was a kid, like we were pretty broke. So I remember like being in the living room, you know, like those fat TVs with like the big back TVs. They used to get hot.
Big batty TVs.
Yeah, the big batty ones. They used to get hot.
So we used to like sit as close as possible to the thing with like me and my brothers, my mum, dad. We just used to like all sit as close as much as possible and watch TV. But I'm sure that fucked up my eyes at some point.
Telling me that I should get a plan B soon. The windshield can't see, trying to work 6 in the morning. That's me. Sometimes I miss all those memories. They pop up back in my mind like remember me. Records stop selling, these people won't care for me. Older you get, the more family is everything.
What? Well, records stop selling, these people won't care for me.
The older you get.
It is true. It is true. Like, relevancy is such a weird thing as well. Because, like, when you're in your prime or, like, when you're doing well, there's a lot of people that come into your life, but then you really find out who really is going to stick around during the dark times. Feels like it should be or could be the last song of the album. I know it's not because you checked earlier, but it feels like it could be an outro song.
Yeah,
like,
you're right.
Just slowly like letting it end for the album.
Is this the song that mentioned that it's gonna, it references or pays homage to?
Yeah, apparently there was a bit that pays homage to Lil Wayne and, not Lil Wayne, sorry, Drake. Eminem and Drake, but.
I didn't catch that.
Nah, didn't catch it at all.
Sorry guys, if we.
If we missed it, let us know in the comments.
Do let us know what we missed so we can, we can smack ourselves in the head then. But it was a good song. Yeah. I enjoyed that song.
No, it was really good. It's a vibey song.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Yeah, just put it on and go on a drive in summer or something. That's kind of
it's a nice song, but you're right, it feels like it's the end of an album kind of song.
Yeah,
it'd be perfect for that
kind maybe of feels like that for us because we're at the end of the album now, so
we actually are in
therapy session. What are your thoughts?
I really enjoyed it. A part of me liked the last one more, you know?
I think I agree, because that's not to say the songs on the last one were better, but I think the messages. Songs on this one, there's some that are so dark, and I was telling you about this as well when I was editing.
Yeah,
so guys, when I was editing the video, like some of the videos, like Therapy Session, How Could You Leave Us, especially, the songs are so good at like it provoking emotions that I was genuinely feeling like it was not ruining my mood, but like it was changing my mood.
Yeah.
Like when I was editing it and stuff, and I'm not sure I would listen to those songs back often because I don't want to like be in that down mood.
Unless you really like feel like
sometimes you need that like
you do, yeah,
but like relatable thing if something's happened in your life or something like that. But in my general like day-to-day life, I would rather listen to something more upbeat or like something a bit happier sometimes as well.
It affects your mood, man.
Yeah.
Good music
affects your mood, especially. And this is really
it does,
good music.
Yeah, it does. This is good music, yeah.
Which is why I'm really excited to get back to the Hope album.
That was so good, yeah.
Because a lot of people were... Because we stopped at Mama, in case you guys didn't know. So we did the first four songs, stopped, and then went back on the full NF journey. But people were saying that's much more of like a upbeat, he's a lot happier in the Hope album as well.
He's fought his demons and he's now
so I'm really excited to get onto that.
There's lots more to cover before we get to the Hope album.
I think there's two
and
more
I'm
albums.
Sure we'll get really good bangers along the way and really good songs along the way, as well as songs that really make us question I guess, where we are and how some people don't always have that luxury,
yeah,
or can be in that same, can't be given the same opportunities as us.
Yeah, 100%.
There'll be lots of different emotions, I'm sure.
And I also think, at the moment, we still haven't seen the full progression quality-wise, because I think Hope NF is still quite a lot better than Therapy Session NF,
it will be,
in terms of his
style.
Because
he's
getting into it now. He's like second
there.
Album, etc. But there's still so much more progression to come, so I'm excited to see that in
the
next albums. But
I'm excited.
I'm excited. We might even do a top five songs from the two. I know we talked about it from the first album and this, but let us know if you guys want to see that.
And thank you guys for
all
taking
the
part in this journey.
All
and
the support.
All the support. And
let's see what's next.
Let's see what's next.